Keyword research is critical to get right. It's arguably the backbone of SEO and content marketing because it's really thinking about how people search for information. Hey there, it's Gerald here from Similarweb, the official measure of the digital world. In the previous video, we took you through the main theories to consider when planning and identifying keyword topics and subtopics. The next part is to identify specific keywords that will help you drive traffic to your website and close the competitive gap. We're here to give you an in-depth look at keyword research using the Similarweb platform. We'll cover different features to help you to make the keyword research process as easy as possible. They are keyword generator, competitive analysis, and keyword gap. First up is keyword generator. Before we go in and look at that particular feature, let's have a look at a few metrics that matter. The first metric that matters in keyword research is search volume. This is all about the return on investment or the ROI to make sure that your and your content teams are focusing on keywords that will actually drive traffic because they are getting searches. That's exactly what search volume is all about. And on the back of that, we want to be looking at the seasonality or the yearly search volume trends of those keywords. You don't want to be optimizing and creating content, for example, on Thanksgiving ideas in the United States when that only happens once a year. As a result, that particular keyword will have a lot of seasonality to it. You want to be looking at yearly search volume trends. This helps you to identify keywords that either have seasonality or don't have seasonality. Keywords that have seasonality can be useful for particular campaigns, for example, Thanksgiving in the United States. But keywords that don't have seasonality, or otherwise called evergreen keywords, are keywords that are consistently searched for throughout the calendar year. Equally so, another really good metric that matters is around keyword relevancy in relation to the buyer's journey. So what would the searcher do after they carry out a search for that keyword? Equally, if you're sharing keywords between organic and paid search teams, you want to find out what is the keyword paid versus organic split. Have a look and be aware of who are the dominant leaders. How competitive is this space? And finally, a metric that directly ties into the buyer's journey is around zero clicks. You don't want to be picking keywords that people search for and then they do nothing on the SERP. This is known as a zero click. So examples of keywords maybe not to go for would be, for instance, duvet or double duvet. These keywords would typically get a lot of searches, for example, over 16,000 of them for double duvet, but actually, that particular keyword also generates 75% zero clicks. In other words, when people do a search for double duvet, they don't actually click, for the most part, on any website. That's not a great keyword. That's why you never look at one metric. Always look at metrics that matter collectively. The best choices would be, for example, double duvet sets, or double duvet sets in grey. These keywords will typically have significantly less searches, but they also have significantly less zero clicks. And as a result, they are likely to drive you traffic. And looking at these keywords, we also can see they have keyword intent, which relates to the consideration and decision stages of the buyer's journey. The next feature we have is competitive analysis. This is where you can come in and find out a list of keywords up to 5 websites or competitors get traffic from. You can go through this list and find out, are any of these relevant for my audience? This is also a really good way to apply those metrics that matter. So in the case of looking through the keywords your competitors rank for, other metrics to be looking for are search volume, seasonal versus all year round evergreen searches, zero clicks, as well as relevancy to your audience. The third and final feature we have to get you started with keyword research is called keyword gap. This feature allows you to specify up to 5 websites at once. It will tell you which keywords do you share overall, which ones are your competitors getting traffic from that you're not, the opportunities, as well as the losses. So which keywords do you share, but you're actually generating significantly less traffic from? This is a really quick and easy way to do competitive keyword research at scale. Again, make sure you're remembering the metrics that matter. The search volume for return on investment, the yearly search volume trends, zero clicks, and crucially, are these keywords relevant to your audience? And remember, When you're doing these keywords, you want to think about content hubs and where they'll be situated within your website. Save and review your keywords, whatever feature you use. Now we're ready to go to the next video, which is all around backlinks. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.